Hello amazing people, welcome back to this channel. Today I want to show you how to solve such problems. A light ray travels from air with refractive index of 1.00 into water with refractive index of 1.33 at an angle of incidence of 45 degrees. What is the approximate refraction angle in water? This problem is a problem on refraction, so the goal is to calculate the amount of bending of the light ray as it moves from air into water. Now we know refraction is the bending of light as it passes from one medium to another with different optical density. And this happens because light changes speed whenever it moves between materials, such as from air, in this case, into water. So let's analyze the problem so we can see how we can solve such problems. So we have a light ray which is incident at an angle of 45 degrees to the normal. And this light ray is traveling from air, and then this is the boundary between air and water. So at the point of incidence, at this point, as light enters into water, it is going to bend, it is going to refract because it has changed a medium with a different refractive index. In this case, depending on how dense or less dense the second medium is, this light ray is going to bend towards that normal or away from the normal. And we are going to shortly see how this happens. So, to solve such a problem, you need the Snell's law. And the Snell's law simply says, N1, which is the refractive index of the first medium from which light is incident or traveling from, sine, the angle of incidence, so theta 1, is always equal to N2, that is the refractive index of the second medium, sine theta 2, that is the angle of refraction. In this case, that is the amount of bending that happens. So from this problem, we are given N1, that is the refractive index of air, to be 1.00. And we are given N2, which is the refractive index of water, which is 1.33. Also, we are given the angle of incidence, that is the light is incident in the first medium, which is air, at an angle of 45 degrees. So we know that, and then it gets refracted in water because it has changed or traveled from one medium into another medium of a different refractive index. So to solve such a problem, let's take our data. So I'll take the data. So N1 is 1.00. N2 is 1.33. What about the angle of incidence? Theta 1, which is 45 degrees. And then theta 2, which is the angle of refraction. That is the unknown, and we are to find that because that is the amount of bending that we are interested in finding. So to do this, we just use the Snell's law. As I've stated, N1. Sine of theta 1 equals N2 sine of theta 2. So let's plug in our values. So we have 1.00 as N1 sine theta 1, which is 45, is equal to N2, in this case 1.33, sine theta 2. So we are looking for theta 2. Now we have to isolate sine of theta 2 so we can find the sine inverse of theta 2 to find theta 2. So to isolate that, we have to divide both sides by 1.33 so we can isolate theta 2. 1.33 here. So that cancels that out. We are left with the right hand side as sine of theta 2 equals the left hand side. So 1.00 times sine of 45 is same as sine of 45 divided by 1.33. Now we can simplify this. So sine of 45 is about 0.707 divided by 1.33. Now if we do 0.707 divided by 1.33, we are going to have sine of theta 2 equals 0.532. And then we can find theta 2 as the sine inverse of 0.532. Now theta 2 is going to be about 32 degrees. And this is the refraction angle, the amount of bend from the normal, right? So as light was incident at the point of incidence with respect to the normal at an angle of 45 degrees, and then this light ray enters the water, it is going to bend towards the normal because the water is denser than air. All right? Great. If you enjoyed this video, if you learned anything new, if you are new to this channel, please subscribe, like, and share so we can have a maximum reach out to other people. I expect to see you in my next video. Until then, bye-bye.